A stranger's stare turned love affair. Days made of habit or believing in magic. Bold lines, best of times, spending nights making rhymes. Black and white or coloring, what you want is what you'll see. If you're looking for it, you'll find it. If you're looking for it, you'll find it. If you're looking for it, you'll find it.
I hope you guys enjoyed the little shop with me clips. I had a lot of fun shopping at South Coast Plaza. I love going to that mall because there's a cb2 there and I'm obsessed with the cb2, but I picked up a couple of things from that day, and I also have a bunch of new home decor pieces that I cannot wait to share with you guys. We have a bunch of stores like cb2, Crate and Barrel, H&M, Amazon, Target, just a bunch of really awesome pieces. And H&M has been my go-to place to shop for home decor. I'm obsessed with their website. I am on H&M Home literally every single day looking for new home decor. I just think their prices are great and their pieces are such high quality and their packaging is amazing. Nothing has ever came broken before. So I'm so obsessed with H&M Home, and yeah, I cannot wait to show you all the pieces that I found. So let's get right into it. Actually, before we do, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up because it would really help out my channel with the algorithm, and it lets me know that you guys enjoy watching these home decor videos with me. All right, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's start with H&M Home. The first thing I have to share are these bubble planters. I have two. I have the largest size and I have the small size. I think there's also a size in between, but it wasn't available at the time I purchased it. Otherwise, I would probably have gotten that too. But I thought this was so adorable. It reminds me of those bubble candles that are really popular right now. But I saw this planter and I just love the design. It is so unique. I love things like this, and the color is just right up my alley. By the way, I have a lot of beige and white decor in here. I'm trying to get better at it, but as I'm looking at this pile, it's basically all white and beige. A little bit of browns and black, but all neutrals. From today on, I'm telling myself that I'm not gonna buy any more white and beige decor. I'm gonna look for like earth tones, woods, and things like that. But for this video, most of it will be basically beige and white. So, love this. The only thing is that these planters don't have drainage holes. And I know that there's a whole like debate on that, if your planter should or shouldn't have one. I know it's definitely a lot more difficult to take care of plants without drainage holes. I actually don't plan on putting plants in these. I do have a small plant that I have been putting in this one. It's a little bit of a hassle of taking it out and draining the water, so that's one thing to look for. Drainage holes whenever you are buying planters, but it was just so adorable and cute that I could not pass it up. And I actually think it would be really nice to just have this out and about like this, or with dry plants. I think with dry plants it would be beautiful, or even just like flowers and fill it up with water. But I actually am just having the larger one on my bookshelf just by itself with nothing in it as a just standalone decor piece. Now, the thing with H&M Home is that their things go quick. You really have to act fast because they will sell out so quickly. So I don't think that they have these on their website anymore, unfortunately. If they do, I will definitely link it. But last time I checked, they came out with a rust colored one, like a darker brown rust color for fall. I thought that was really pretty too, so I'll definitely look for it. Hopefully it's still on their website. Next, I have this very interesting vase, and I'm so drawn to the shape. I love it. I think it's so unique and interesting and really just fun, so I love it. And I don't know what I'm gonna put in it yet. Maybe some dry pampas grass or flowers, or just kind of have it as a decor piece alone. And they have a bunch of things like this on their website. So this is one of my favorite ones. Yeah, I love this, and I'm just so happy. Their prices are pretty good as well. This was around like $30, and they always have coupons on their website. So I'm pretty sure I got all of this for like 20% off. So definitely check out for their sales. Moving on, we have the classic, the iconic donut vase. I feel like everybody and their moms have something like this, and of course I had to get my hands on it too. I have this like shelving console thing under my TV, and there's this little nook that would be perfect for this, so I put it over there. And I have some, well not right now, but I put some bunny tails in it. I think bunny tails, rabbit tails, something tails, but a dried leaf. Is it a leaf? They do have two sizes. This is the largest size. They have a smaller one that I am so tempting to buy, but I'm like, no, when you do not need two donut vases, just one is enough. But I love it. It's so cute, and it's again very well made. This is part of their sculptural line, I think. So it has a really nice weight to it. It's pretty heavy. Love this so much. And then the last sculptural vase I have is this one. How cute. And this one I think would be really nice paired with one of these other vases, just kind of like layered. I love playing with different levels when it comes to decorative pieces. I think it makes it a little bit more interesting that way, and it draws the eye. So I love that this vase is a little bit smaller, and I love that all the vases here have a smaller opening. I just prefer smaller openings when it comes to vases. This one, I think I'm just gonna have it be a standalone decorative piece, but of course you could put something in here. Again, flowers, dried grass, whatever that floats your boat, but I think this would just be nice and minimal just by itself. So that's what I'm planning to do with it. And I just love their vases. I think they're all very, just so unique, and I love that most of them are in neutral colors. All right, next I have this cute little tea candle holder. I don't have any tea candles. I don't know if I'm gonna buy some, but I just like having this alone on my desk or on the coffee table just to add some color to my space. And I just love the color. It is this beautiful amber, really great for fall coming up, and I want to get more pieces that are in this color. So really happy with this one, and it was only like $5, so really affordable. All right, next I have this little tray right here. This is supposed to be a soap tray, I think. It's made out of bamboo, and immediately when I saw this, I bought two because I was planning on putting my soap dispensers on it. So I have my soap dispenser from Amazon, and I put this in my kitchen. I have two of these on my kitchen. I have one for dish soap and one for hand soap, and I'm planning to just put it on top like this. And I just think that is so cute and adorable. You can even use this for your bathroom as well. I feel like you can get really creative with this and use it in multiple different ways. Dispensers, maybe even jewelry, that would be kind of cute. So yeah, I love this little bamboo tray here. All right, next I went to At Home and I picked up this fruit basket. We were using it for fruits, but then we stopped because we actually just put all of our fruits in the fridge. We like eating cold fruits. So this basket was just hanging out on our counter with nothing in it. And I thought, I'm gonna put all of my Nespresso pots in here. So I have all of my Nespresso pots in here, and I think that is such a cute way to display it on the counter, and that way it's not cluttered in our cabinets. This I bought at Home for around $10, I think, and I found the exact one at Crate & Barrel, and they were selling theirs for $50. 50 bucks. So don't go to Crate & Barrel, go to At Home because you can save a fraction. So definitely go there. Next we have CB2, and the first thing I picked up is this ginormous planter. I have a fiddle leaf plant and I'm planning to put that in here. So this one again doesn't have any drainage holes, which is a little annoying. So we have to figure out what we're gonna do. We might just have to make it work, but this was actually on sale. So I can't believe this was on sale. This is so cute. I love the design of this one, and the texture is really interesting too. It looks like kind of like dried paint. So there is just some really interesting textures going on here. And I love playing with different like tones of beiges and textures when it comes to decor, so that's not just all like flat beige and white. So I love this, and it is so heavy, so I'm gonna put it down. And I actually bought the smaller version of it as well. This was also on sale from CB2, and I have a little plant in here, and I got this plant from Pigment in San Diego. So it fits perfectly in this little planter, and I just have this on my bookshelf, and I just think it's so adorable, so cute. Again, it's just a smaller version of that larger planter, so I love the details here. Next, I have this jewelry box, and I've been eyeing this on CB2 for the longest time. I finally got it because I had a coupon, so I used it on this little jewelry box, and this is the largest size actually. Not so little, but it is so heavy. All of their pieces, especially their stoneware pieces, are really great quality, and they have a nice weight to them. I just love, again, the texture and the design of this one. It has these lines on it, and it has this gold strip right here, and it just opens up to a velvet interior like that, so that way you can put your jewelry on here. It's not going to damage your jewelry. It's really protective. And I was using this for jewelry, but then I decided to use this as decor for my living room. So I have this on my bookshelf. I don't have anything in it. I just felt like it was too pretty to be hiding out in my closet. I needed to show it off in my living room, and yeah, I don't know, maybe I'll find some use for this in the future and put something in it. But so far it's gonna be for decor, and I'm not mad about it, so love this. Next I have these champagne glasses, and they are so aesthetically pleasing, are they not? Come on. I love these, and they were out of stock for the longest time. I think these are a fan favorite. They have a ton of reviews on their website, and they finally were in stock, so I picked them up. And I am not planning to drink champagne in this. I actually bought it because I wanted to eat ice cream with it. I know it's a very bougie way to eat ice cream, but whatever, I don't care. Or sometimes, you know, I could put some, I don't know, juice in here or something, or maybe like Moscato, I don't know. But I actually got it because I saw a photo online and people were putting ice cream in it and candy, and I thought, oh, that looks so delicious and yummy. And so I bought this for dessert purposes. So I feel like the stem is short enough so that way you could use it for ice cream and things like that. I know that CB2 can be a little pricey sometimes, especially their furniture, but I found that their kitchenware and bathroom accessories are actually priced quite affordable. So I really love these, and I think I got them for like $10 a glass. So I only have two, but yeah, I love this, and I cannot wait to eat ice cream in it. Another piece that I picked up from CB2 is this matte black tray, and I am using this in my bathroom because I have a black bathroom set from Amazon, and I was looking for a tray to put all those accessories on, and I found this, so that way I can put my soap dispenser, my, you know, jars and all that stuff on here, and it matches perfectly. And this was around, I think it was like $12 each. It's really nice quality. It's glazed with this matte black coating. Not much to say about this little rectangular tray here, just very nice quality and useful. And they also have a white version as well. So I completely forgot to show you guys this CB2 vase when I was filming my sit down video. So here's a clip of it. I am so in love with this vase, you guys. It is the perfect height for my pampas grass. And I love how large it is. I love the color and the texture. Oh my God, the texture, incredible. It looks very unfinished as if it was dug from the ground up. You know what I mean? I love the vintage look and feel of it. I'm just so in love with this one. So definitely check out CB2 for their vases and decorative objects. I am so in love with this one. This little watering can, I got this from Amazon, and H&M Home actually has the exact same one, but theirs were a little bit more expensive, so I opted for the Amazon version, and it's literally the same thing. So this one is really cute, very minimal. I know this comes in a lot of different colors, even like gold and silver as well. So love this little watering can, just simple. All right, next I have this decorative arch from Target, and this is from the Studio McGee line, and it's just a really nice simple piece to add anywhere, either on your desk, on your coffee table, your bookshelf. I've been wanting to get some sort of marble decorative object, and the ones from CB2 are gorgeous, but they're a little pricey. And I found this one from Target for a fraction of that price, and I feel like this is something that you could totally see at CB2. So I picked this up and I'm so happy with it. I think it's really pretty and just minimal, and I love the arch shape. So yeah, I'm just really in love with anything that is like curvy and round. All right, we are almost done. Just a couple more pieces left. And the last store is Ikea, good old Ikea. The first thing that I picked up are these wooden salt and pepper grinders. And these are humongous. I mean, look how big they are. These definitely command attention in the kitchen. I actually found this through my friend Kim because she recently uploaded her furnished apartment tour video. You should totally check it out. And she had these in her kitchen and I had to go to Ikea right away and pick it up. You can use these for a lot of things, but the most common is salt and pepper. So I do have that in here and they work perfectly. And I just love the way they look right against my white backsplash. I think it pops and it adds some nice earthy tones. I'm really trying to buy more like wooden tones to fill up my kitchen and living room because there's just a lot of like black and white in here, which is fine, but I want to add more wooden tones and browns to my decor. So I thought this would be perfect, and yeah, I just love these. All right, next I have this simple vase, and this I think would be really pretty with some baby's breath. This was so affordable. I think this was only like $1.50, so super affordable and just a really fun pretty vase. So yeah, love this. And then next I have this little hanging basket. I have the tag on here because I still haven't got around to putting my plants in here yet, but we already hung up some lights and plants in the balcony, and I'm planning to switch out the plastic planters to these ones here. And I just think that would be nice hanging on the ceiling of the balcony. We have four of these that we bought, and they were around $8 each, so pretty affordable. And one thing I forgot to mention actually are the pillows right beside me right here. We bought these from Target and I'm obsessed with these pillows. They are so comfortable and they are huge. I love them. My lighting is just totally washing them out, but they have this like square window panel design on them, so they're not just plain beige. They have some texture on here, which I really love. So I love adding neutral colors, of course, like ivories and whites and beiges, but I like picking out things that have some interesting aspects, like different textures, different tones, and just, I don't know, I think it creates diversity in the whole apartment. That way it's not just flat and bland. So I love this, and I especially love doing the karate chop. Hi-ya! Hi-ya! Yeah. All right, so that's gonna be the end of my home decor haul. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun creating these pieces and I'm definitely not done. I'm still in the process of really making this space feel like my home, our home, and I'm just having a lot of fun in the process. So definitely look out for more home content coming up. And thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys really enjoyed it and I will just see you guys in my next one. Okay, bye guys.